gets old.
No, it does not.
Absolutely. It's a new dance every day.
A new dance every day, especially when it comes to trying to stay informed. Thank you so much for joining us here for KARE 11 News at Noon. Listen, Lynx fans are celebrating today with the final series now on the calendar. Mm-hmm. We've got more on their crucial win in just a bit. But first, the biggest story across the nation right now is Hurricane Milton.
That's right. Milton is expected to make landfall late tonight into tomorrow. We're tracking its path, and I've got a look at the preparations happening in those final moments.
First, let's take a look at our first weather here. Much different.
Yes, very quiet. Not much has changed over the last really month and a half or so, honestly. It's already 67 degrees. Temperatures are going to be a skosh warmer today than what we saw yesterday. More sunshine. The wind starting to kick up from the south and east. That will help to boost our temperatures. And also, nothing but sunshine. That's been basically the case over the last couple of weeks or so as well. Let's check out your hour by hour forecast. It does take us into the 70s by 1 o'clock this afternoon. Temperatures peaking mid to upper 70s, and I think some parts of southwest Minnesota could graze near 80 degrees. And your main weather headline, the pleasant weather continues. Temperatures are likely going to peak tomorrow. Most of us will be back in the lower 80s, feeling more like maybe late August or early September than the middle part of October. Then several dry cold fronts bring us back to reality this weekend. And by the time we head into next week, Monday morning, Tuesday morning, we could be talking about our first widespread frost across the region. So, of course, we'll talk more about that forecast in a couple minutes.
It's hard to think about that when the biggest story right now is to our south. Mm-hmm. You know, you've been tracking Hurricane Milton throughout the week. I know we've seen some fluctuation. What are we seeing right now?
It's still a major hurricane, and it still is forecast to make landfall later on tonight, likely near and just after midnight across the Gulf Coast of Florida. This is a live look at radar right now, and a couple of things I want to point out. First off, you zoom in a little bit closer. You can see this part right here. That's the eye of the storm, and you can see the heavy thunderstorm surrounding that eye wall, backing things up a little bit. It's not just the eye wall we're concerned with. Notice all the tornado warnings that have popped up over central and western Florida right now. As the system is moving onshore, there's a lot of twisting motion, and we're actually seeing the development of supercell thunderstorms that are already impacting Florida's coast, despite the fact that the eye of the storm is still 120 miles offshore. Now, it has lost its Category 5 status. It is currently a Category 4 storm as of noon today, with wind gusts, or wind speeds, I should say, at 145 miles per hour. Over the last 6 hours, you can see the eye has enclosed up a little bit, so it is encountering what we call wind shear. It's starting to break apart a little bit, but it's still forecast to still maintain that major hurricane status as it moves onshore later on this evening. Still by Wednesday evening, by sundown, wind speeds of 125 miles per hour. It's still forecast to make landfall somewhere between Tampa Bay and the Fort Myers area, and the biggest concern with this is going to be storm surge. Not necessarily how strong the wind is, but just how high that water gets. The forecast has shifted slightly where the worst storm surge is forecast to be. Now it's from Sarasota to South Venice, the Cape Coral area, Port Charlotte. All these areas in red could potentially see anywhere between 10 and 15 feet of storm surge. So again, it's not necessarily the wind and the flooding. It's just how much or how high that water is going to be. And that's something that we'll be watching very closely. And as we do keep an eye on the storm, Cece, what else are we seeing on the ground in terms of preparations?
Yeah, you know, as Ben was saying, things are already starting up. I mean, at this point in the day, the window of opportunity is closing to evacuate. The entire state is now in the hurricane's path. And look at this, though. This afternoon, it appears that a lot of people are listening to officials' advice to get out. We've seen lines of traffic heading out of town. Many gas stations are out of fuel by now, and entire neighborhoods look deserted, as you see here. All of this comes as this monster storm moves toward the state. This is a live look at Key West, Florida right now. As you can see, those waves, that water is very angry right now. I do see a person standing out there right now. We've seen people out there leaving the area too. According to the National Hurricane Center, right around now is when tropical storm conditions are expected to start impacting the west coast of Florida. Officials say this storm will bring significant risk of flooding, rain, and hurricane force winds, and with wind speeds expected to be close to 120 miles per hour, debris left behind from Hurricane Helene could quickly turn into deadly projectiles.
If you have not evacuated, bug out. If you don't take heed, you're on your own. You might as well take a Sharpie and write your name and social security number on your leg so that when we find you, we have a contact, because it is not going to be good for you.
A lot of warnings there. AP reporter spoke to residents leaving this morning. One man who plans to flee to his daughter's home inland said his roommate already left. He said he told her to, quote, pack like you aren't coming back. So just scary and heartbreaking moments for everyone living down there right now, Alexis.
Man, lots of tough realities for the folks down there. And just a few hours ago, FEMA had a message for Floridians. What did they have to say?
Yeah, you know, they just assured them that they're ready to respond to this storm, but they also talked about the intensity of this hurricane like we've been doing for days and stressed the importance of staying safe and heeding those warnings to get out of there.
Cece, thank you so much for staying on top of that for us. And we will be tracking this Hurricane Milton as it nears land tonight. And of course, we're going to be bringing you the latest both on air and online at KARE11.com.